Watching today in breaking news for the first time, Australia has imposed cyber sanctions against a Russian citizen, Aleksandr Ermakov, over his role in the 2022 Medibank cyber hack.
Let's bring in Nine political editor Charles Croucher and Today tech expert Trevor Long. Charles, let's start with you. What do these sanctions include?
Sarah, it is the first time Australia has used these sanctions. It includes a travel ban for Mr. Ermakov. He won't be able to come to Australia, which is his loss, frankly. But it also includes punishments for anyone or any company that is interacting with him. And that's where these punishments attempt to effectively cut off the sourcing for Mr. Ermakov. It's a criminal offence with 10 years of jail and heavy fines to either finance, provide assets, or use Mr. Ermakov's assets in some way, and that includes paying any ransomware. So effectively you are, or the government is attempting to cut off any form of financing or giving assets to Aleksandr Ermakov and what the minister called Russian cyber gangs that he works for. This is an ongoing effort under Operation Aquila. It has been in collaboration with the FBI, the NSA in America, and also the GCHQ in the UK, utilising those Five Eyes experts. My colleague and our National Affairs editor, Andrew Probyn, is across this story. He'll bring some exclusive details throughout the day and on Nine News tonight on exactly how they track this guy down. So
all right.
Look forward to.
Just on the other part of the element of that announcement, 12 people, three entities linked to Hamas. Any more detail on that?
Yeah, we did. We were talking about whether they were foreign or domestic. These are all foreign entities. There's 12 people and three entities linked to Hamas, Hezbollah and Palestinian-backed Islamic Jihad. This is in line with what the US and UK have announced overnight as well. So Australia providing a joint approach to these people and these organisations.
OK.
All right. Well, Trevor, let's bring you in now. We know that millions of Australians were affected by that Medibank hack. So do these sanctions against this Russian cyber attack really make an impact? Is this going to have any kind of send any warnings to other hackers out there?
Morning, Sarah. All it really does is let other hackers know that Australia is strong in trying to track down people who commit these crimes. Whether or not the sanctions actually mean anything is to really be determined, because it's unlikely he wants to travel and it's unlikely anyone in Australia is probably funding him at this point. But if you are, you're on notice. Really, what this does is tell Australians that the government is working hard. I don't know that it's going to put off any overseas hackers at this point, because the Australian government's tentacles don't really reach that far.
It's another sign, though, of how aware we need to be from a retail point of view with the number of people trying to hack into our systems and also hack into our own personal items.
We need everyone to be on alert. Now, I would argue that the sanctions against this guy stop any of us paying a ransom to this guy. Now, we don't normally know who we're paying a ransom to. So 10 years prison if you pay a ransom off ransomware on your computer. So a warning to all businesses to take cybersecurity seriously, to work with the Australian government and Scamwatch and all those organisations to make sure that you do the right thing when you are a victim and you tell your businesses and your customers, but also take cybersecurity seriously. If the government's taking it seriously, so should businesses, and hopefully businesses get major fines in the future, because while it's great that Medibank helped out here, they shouldn't have let this happen in the first place.
Good on you, Charlie, and thank you to Trevor. I'll let you get on with your day.
Now, Charles, we heard a bit about the Medibank cyber hack and also about some Hamas-linked entities and people. Do we know more about that?
Yeah, separate sanctions. I think there's 12, Penny Wong was saying, people that have been linked to Hamas, also to Palestinian Islamic Jihad and Hezbollah that have been announced in that pretty wide-ranging press conference there. The crux of that gathering between the Deputy Prime Minister, the Foreign Minister and the Home Affairs Minister was that there are cyber sanctions that are being invoked against Aleksandr Ermakov. It is a Russian national that the government believe is responsible for the Medibank hack that compromised the data of 9 million Australians. That will be frozen assets and travel bans. This is the first time these sanctions have been used. They are said to be world-leading here in Australia and the first time they have been used. Now, I can't imagine Mr. Ermakov is planning to travel to Australia anytime soon, so the travel bans probably don't count for much, but the financial sanctions and more so naming the individual is what's happened here. Effectively, the government government is saying. We have smart and tough people, to use the minister's words, here that are chasing down those responsible for cyber attacks. Now, that is seen as a warning to those that would sort or seek to attack Australian institutions, Australian organisations, Australian businesses in the future. So that's there. The other thing is, they said this is hugely significant and unprecedented. Also working with the FBI and the NSA in America and the GCHQ in the UK. So that goes back to the idea this is the Five Eyes intelligence partners, Australia, New Zealand, America, Canada, all coming together, and the UK, all coming together to operate and work on this problem that is a global problem and often doesn't have borders. So that is a warning to those cyber criminals out there that these effectively Russian cyber gangs, as the minister said, would be tracked down. Now, how do you punish them when Russia's not cooperating? That becomes a challenge for the future.
Well, and how does any of the punishment, how do any of the sanctions realistically work apart from the headline that they've been named and shamed? I don't even know how much shame they're going to be feeling from a practical point of view, and how much, therefore, is it a deterrent for other gangs who they say are operating in the field?
Yeah, some of those sanctions involve and can be taken out against people who aid or assist or finance some of these cyber gangs, and that goes to more people either paying ransoms in some circumstances or paying using things like cryptocurrency, paying into those organisations. So that is preventing or attempting to prevent the funds that go into them, effectively cutting off this reason for doing some of the cyber attacks. That's the idea. Again, how practical and how effective it is, we'll have to wait and see.
Just in relation to, I think we were more surprised about these 12 people linked with three entities to Hamas. We didn't get much detail on that. It may have come in that press conference afterwards, and perhaps it will come in the coming hours. But that is a serious concern.
Yeah, I suspect we will get more detail in the coming minutes or next sort of half an hour or so. The foreign minister is still talking, so it's deep in the weeds into that the cybersecurity element of it, but we'll get more information there. As you said, not just Hamas, but Palestinian-backed Islamic Jihad and also Hezbollah. So this follows Penny Wong's trip to the Middle East. That's happened. Of course, it is ahead of the cabinet meeting, which is happening in the next couple of hours here as well. So significant movements in a number of places, all against the backdrop of this huge cost of living relief that's coming as well. So lots to come out of here in the next few hours, I'd imagine.
We don't even know if these people are these people in Australia.
Yeah, whether they're Australian based.
Sorry, mate. I'm just
curious.
Exactly.
About it too,
it's a good question, because that is the concern, right? It always has been that there would be an influence from the conflict in the Middle East, horrific on so many ways, but that would seep into Australia, and somehow this would become a battleground here in Australia for the fight that's going on the far side of the world. So that is a concern. I don't know the answer to that, but we'll find out.
And whether or not Penny Wong gathered some more intel while she was over there as well.
Imagine so.
There's a bit on there today, as you rightly point
out.
Good on you, Charlie. We'll let you go to it and appreciate that.